Hello, and welcome to Reality, the photorealistic virtual studio solution from Zero Density. I would like to start with the news that we were the winners for the IBC Innovation Award. So we thank very much for all the partners. This fine example of set design was created by Andy Blondin, a technical artist at Epic Games, and kindly provided for our use by Zach Field, Senior Vice President of Fox Sports. So we thank them very much for their help and support. Before going into too much technical detail, I would like to talk a few things about important aspects of virtual studio production and also the differences of reality in terms of competition and our technology. So, as you probably already know, reality is based on a AAA gaming engine called Unreal Engine. But the way we handle the integration with Unreal Engine is way different than the competition and the traditional approach. So as you would agree with me, with conventional approach, the virtual studio, everything is a layer. The background is a computer-generated image, and there is one layer with the talent, the key talent, and there is one more layer for the graphics elements that should be on the front. This is called a layer-based composition, but reality is totally different because reality has been developed from scratch as a fork of Unreal to be a node-based video processing engine built on top of Unreal as a renderer. Speaking about components, there are many components that form up a virtual studio solution, but the most important one of them is the keyer. Reality has its own keyer called Reality Keyer, which is a software-based, a GPU-accelerated, high-performance, high-quality keyer that is 3D aware. I will come to that 3D aware section a little bit later, but now I want to focus on the quality. Okay, so. Our keyer can handle soft shadows really well. And this is important because without the soft shadows, you cannot have these contact shadows that will make your talent actually look like he's walking on the floor. Without those contact shadows, you're actually floating around. And people have really problems with those shadows because they look really bad and then they want to get rid of it by clipping it. They're afraid of it. And there are two problems when you do that. One, you lose your shadows, meaning you're floating around, it's not a good composition. And second, even worse, you lose detail because you're clipping your level of detail in your keyer. So if Duya can tilt up and zoom in to my head a little bit, and maybe focus Duya a little bit, okay, so you probably see even a single strand of my hair. This is Reality Keyer in action. And we can be a little bit more. Courageous and have this, you know, transparent water bottle in my hand. So as you can see, Reality Keyer has no compromise in quality when it comes to details like transparent objects or soft shadows, and in general, we believe Reality Keyer is the best performing keyer on the market today. Another killer feature of Reality is depth of field. So my friend using the camera will zoom to me a little bit and then change the focus. And as you can see, the graphics adapts in terms of depth of field to this change. We receive all the information from the lens. It has been pre-calibrated. We know the focal distance of the lens. So we match the optical depth of field with graphical depth of field in terms of distance. And the result is a very natural, realistic looking depth of field effect, which is very important. Reality will take advantage of all the post-processing effects that are available in the Unreal pipeline, like the lens flares. We just enabled them, we exaggerated them a little bit for you to see better, but you're in control of the shape, sizes, and intensity of those lens flares, obviously. But the lens flares themselves are not that important. The important thing here is the composition, because if you look carefully enough, you will see the lens flares are in front of me. This is not possible with a layer-based system. It is not easy to put these lens flares on top of graphics because I'm in front of them, right? So we are internally composited, not a layer-based system, and that's one of the proofs. That video wall behind me, as you can see, any text, any object that you design in the Unreal set, the Unreal design, that has a texture on it can be a target for our live sources. In this case, my friend just picked the live input coming from directly from the camera. It could have been another source or a clip that is played back right from your reality engine. So far, we always displayed a full green application, green screen application, but this year we decided to take it a little bit further so we can show you how you can switch between the virtual world to the real world. When you're in the physical area, you can use augmented elements in your set. So Philip will just turn left a little bit so you can see our basketball board with nice materials and textures and translucency in it, and also it casts shadow to the wall behind it and to the video wall behind me. If you can see, these are all dynamic shadows created by reality and composited by our node-based processing engine. In order to give you a more example of a dynamic shadow, there's another augmented element here, the basketball. So my friend will play the animation for the basketball that we created. Ball up. Yep, thank you. So ball up, ball down. Now you see the dynamic lights, dynamic shadows. These are not texture fakes. These are placed accurately using coordinates of our physical lights, and that's what you should do on your augmented applications. You can replace your physical lights with virtual lights so the shadow environment will be exactly as it should be. So, as you can see, this green water bottle that I'm holding is not keyed because our keyer knows which areas to key and which areas not to key. And we achieve that by having an internal geometry renderer which renders simple shapes. We created a simple version of our physical set, nothing special, like just a cyclorama object here, a rectangular object for this part, a planner object for this part, and we create a 3D mask that is inputted into our keyer, and then we indicate those ranges, hey, don't key this area, so this, the result is our object is not keyed here, but will be keyed as soon as it enters into a green area. Again, a 3D mask can be applied to our keyer for you to understand, for you to force the keyer to do several things in several regions. Again, a very unique feature of reality. You see that there are a lot of green spill here, spilling from the green wall behind me. Well, again, with reality, using this 3D masking technique, we have created a simple mask, just a little rectangle around this area to tell the keyer, not key, but take the green out of that area, okay? You switch and show the people how we take the spill out of the physical areas. Again, a very unique detail that reality keyer has. It's really, really important. Speaking of augmented elements, we have improved our augmented objects so that you can have shadows, obviously, but also the reflections of the surrounding environment are also reflected over the reflective surfaces of your objects. In this case, this is a piano, it could have been anything. But remember, we are in the augmented area right now. Okay, that is really, really a unique feature of reality. So let's show the ceiling first. As you can see, we also replaced the ceiling like a set extension. You don't need to use your own physical environment. We can replace it with augmented elements to be a replacement for your physical or an extension of your physical set. We could have done the same thing to the left side of this area. In a nutshell, reality gives you all the tools. It's the ultimate tool for all your virtual production needs. Simple green screen, blue screen applications, pure augmented applications with augmented shadows and relighting, or hybrid ones like the one that we displayed you today. So this was reality. Thank you very much for watching.